I told you that there are two important things to remember with Monte Carlo integration. One is that you can easily generate draws and calculate an approximation of the integral by applying the function and calculating the mean. But two is that what you obtain is just an approximation. So the question is, how good or how bad is this approximation? And this is what we will discuss in the following slides, is what is the accuracy of the approximation that we calculate. So remember, we wanted to calculate this integral, and we consider the integral as the expectation of a transform of a random variable capital X. And we approximate this integral by calculating the empirical mean of transforms of draws from this random variable. This approximation we will denote by I hat in the following analysis. The first thing to say is that this approximation is unbiased. It means that if we calculate the error, so what is the error? The error is I hat minus the true expectation. Okay? So this is the error. Well, in average, this error is equal to zero. So this is called unbiasedness. The approximation is unbiased. It's good news. But if we want to know about the precision, we need to look at the variance of this approximation. So what is the variance of this error? Basically, the variance is calculated as the ratio between the variance of g of x divided by capital R. And here you get the intuition. If g of x has a high variability, you will need more draws to get a precise value of the expectation. And the fact that capital R is at the denominator shows that if you increase the number of draws, you will decrease the variance of the estimator. But how do we calculate this? Well, actually, we don't need a precise value for the variance. We just need a rough idea about the precision. So we will approximate the variance. The variance of g of x, what is the definition? So remember, the definition of the variance is the expectation of the square minus the square of the expectation. This is just the definition of variance. But now I can use simulation to estimate this quantity. Like I did for the integral, I can always approximate these expectations using simulation. So for the first term, I can calculate the mean, the empirical mean over all draws that I have generated of g x r squared. Okay, this is the approximation of the first term of the variance using simulation, using the exact same idea that I presented before. And for the second term, well, this is nothing else than my integral, right? And I have approximated it using I hat. So I can replace this expectation by I hat, and I obtain this formulation. So here I have a convenient way to calculate the variance of g of x using draws that I have generated anyway. Remember, I had to generate the draws to calculate I hat, the approximation of the integral. So I can recycle the draws in this formula to calculate an approximation of var of gx. And this approximation of var of gx can be used to obtain an approximation of the variance of the error that I'm making by doing the approximation. And this is very useful, because now I can derive two important information from this analysis of variance. First, I can have a confidence interval. So in this case, I can say that the true value of the integral, which I denote here by capital I, it's unbiased, so it's centered at I hat. And if I take the 95% interval, I take the quantile of the normal distribution. And here, ER, based on the derivation that we made in the previous slide, is the variance of g of x divided by R square root. Okay, this is the standard error of the error that we make using this approximation. but we can also derive the number of draws. So let's assume that I want an approximation of my integral with a given precision that I denote by kappa here. So now I can say that in order to obtain this precision, I need at least capital R draws, where R must be larger or equal to this quantity, the variance of g of x divided by kappa square. And we have seen in the previous slide, again, how to estimate the variance of g of x. So this is very convenient because in practice, I can decide based on the precision that I want, the number of draws that I will have to generate. And as you can see here, if the precision increases, well, the number of draws will have also to increase. So this is equivalent to say that the variance of the error is bounded by kappa square, or equivalently, that the standard error of the error is bounded by kappa. So again, kappa is an upper bound on the error that you want to make. So this is what I call the desired precision. And you can calculate the number of draws that you need to reach that precision. Okay, but let's come back to choice models. So far, I have introduced the concept of Monte Carlo integration in general. The idea is simple. We consider the integral as the expectation of the random variable. We draw from that random variable, and we calculate the empirical mean to have an approximation of the integral. Let's come back to the concept of mixtures that we saw in the previous video, where we were considering an error component model, where we included two error components in the utility function, one for probit, a component called xi that has a normal distribution, and one for logit, a component called nu, which has a 9-ID extreme value distribution. And this is what we derived in this context. We had a logit model conditional to the knowledge of xi, and the choice model itself required to integrate over xi, which basically is equivalent to take the expectation over xi of the conditional probability. So this is the same concept that we just discussed in the context of Monte Carlo integration. An integral is the same as an expectation. How do you do it in biology? It's very simple, actually. We follow the same logic. We define xi as draws, and we have to specify here the distribution of the draws, a normal distribution in this case. Then we write a utility function, so vi is equal to beta x plus xi, exactly as we showed in the previous equation. Then we write the conditional probability that I call prob here. In this case, it's a logit model. And then to do the integration, I calculate the log of the probability as the here the Monte Carlo approximation of the integral, and I apply the log. I refer you to the BioGym webpage for more details about the syntax. But the objective here is to show you that it's very simple. You follow the same logic that I presented in the equations when you implement the model. Let's do it. Let's apply BioGym on a simple example based on the specification that you have just introduced. So here I have two alternatives, I and j. The utility of I is a constant, minus 10, plus an error term which is normally distributed, 5 xi I, and an error term which is extreme value distributed, nu I. And I assume that in the second alternative, j, I have only the new j term for the sake of having a simple example. I have calculated an approximation of the integral using many draws, and I reach the value of 3%. So 3% is the probability to select alternative I using this model. So this is what I call the reference value. So this is the one that I have obtained with 10 million draws. And then I plot here as the x-axis the number of draws, and as the y-axis the approximation of the probability of I. As you can see in the early iterations, the approximation is quite poor. But then, as we expect from the theory, as R increases, we will converge to the good value. Something which is interesting to look at is the log of the probability, because this is actually what we use in the log likelihood function. But globally, we have the same property, so asymptotically it will converge, but the problem with the log of the probability, it is a biased estimate of the value. And the reason why it's a biased estimate is because the log of a sum is different from the sum of the log. And this is why the log probability approximated using Monte Carlo integration is not an unbiased estimate of the true log probability. So what is the impact on parameters estimation? Well, if we look at maximum likelihood, we need to solve this optimization problem. And the issue is that this integral is not tractable. Therefore, we replace maximum likelihood estimation by maximum simulated likelihood estimation, where the model is replaced by this approximation provided by the Monte Carlo approximation. And as I mentioned in the previous slide, while P hat is a non-biased estimate of P from the theory of Monte Carlo integration, this is not the case for log of P hat. It is not a non-biased estimate of log of P, because its log is a non-linear transform of the probability. Monte Carlo integration consists in considering an integral as the expectation of a random variable. An empirical approximation of the mean of the random variable, which is obtained from simulation, is used as an approximation of the integral. The larger the number of draws we use, the better the approximation. And in the context of mixtures of logit, it consists in calculating the mean of many logit models, as we have seen.